Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. My name is Rima Bader. I'm a professor of pediatric and fetal cardiology at King Abdulaziz University Hospital, Jeddah, Saudi Arabia. I was privileged to come to the ESMF, Egyptian Society of Fetal Medicine, third international meeting, and I gave a talk on fetal hearts. And it's basically that when we talk about fetal hearts scanning and abnormal cases, and in this case we do like 2D echocardiography to check the anatomy, to check first of all the four chamber view, and then the outflow tracts and the arch and the three vessels view. And as we know that if we do scanning only for the four chamber view, we can detect about 60% of the congenital heart anomalies. But if we add the outflow tracts, then we get up to 80 to 85% detection of anomalies. So when we start fetal scanning, we have to do the, of course, the basics, which is going to be the situs and going to be the area of the heart compared to the thoracic area, so the CTA ratio. And then we look at the four chamber view. And when we look at the four chamber view, we look at the atria and the ventricles, and we try very much to have a proper four chamber view, looking right atrium, right ventricle, left atrium, left ventricle. But what's important is in the fetus, usually we don't go by saying the mitral valve, if we find it, it's a left, right or left heart, or we have to go and know which one is the mitral valve. So the mitral valve is usually the offsetting of the valve is different from the tricuspid valve. And what we know is that the ventricle follows the valve. So if I identify the tricuspid valve, which is the offsetting of the valve is going to be more towards the apex, then the ventricle will follow the valve. And so this is the right ventricle. But we don't go by saying that the right ventricle is the anterior ventricle and the left ventricle is the posterior ventricle. We go by the valve anatomy and the ventricle follows the valve. This is a very important point in the four chamber view. And then we look at the atria. Is the right atrium opening into the right ventricle? Is the left atrium opening into the left ventricle? Now, when we go for the right atrium, we don't go by saying that the SVC is opening in the right atrium, so this is the right atrium. We go by the foramen ovale flap, which direction? So that when we see the opening of the foramen ovale, then we know that this is the left atrium. So if I see the opening of the foramen ovale into the left atrium, then I can easily say this is atrioventricular concordance. So the left atrium is opening to the left ventricle. So again, the valve is the one that tells us which ventricle it is. So if I see the tricuspid valve and I know the offsetting is different, this is the right ventricle. And the other hallmark to identify right ventricle is the presence of a moderator bank. So now I know the right ventricle and now I know the left ventricle. I look at them and I say it's atrioventricular concordance, right? And then I go into a little bit more colder towards the head, looking for the ventriculo-arterial concordance, i.e. if the ventricle is opening into the right ventricle is open to pulmonary artery, and if the left ventricle is opening into the aorta. So we call this ventriculo-arterial concordance. And this is very important. And I can't say the vessel is coming out of the right ventricle's pulmonary artery just because it's there, because we have a disease called transposition of great arteries, which will simulate a normal heart if it's an intact ventricular septum. No, I have to see the valve, the pulmonary artery from the right ventricle bifurcating. So this is then the pulmonary artery. And if I see the aorta coming out of the left ventricle, this is the aortic arch, and I can see the arch turning, and I can see the neck vessels coming out of the arch. So again, just because the vessel is coming out of the right ventricle does not mean it's pulmonary artery. And if the vessel is coming out of the left ventricle, does not mean it's aortic artery, aortic arch. So this is a very important point. This is a second learning point in scanning the four chamber view. And this is the importance of outflow tract measurements, because you can easily miss transposition of great arteries if we don't do the outflow tracts. And another thing, if we don't go a little bit caudal, we can miss the trilogy of fallot as well. So when I scan the four chamber view, I do the 2D without color. I look at the intraventricular septum, I'd look, as we said, into the foramen ovale opening. Now, the second thing, before I leave the four-chamber view, I throw color and look at the AV valve regurgitations, which is the mitral and tricuspid. I look for regurgitation of the mitral valve, regurgitation of the tricuspid valve. Also, I look for any defects in the septum, in the ventricular septum. So this will be my view of looking at the ventricular septum defects. So when I throw color, of course, we have to know, if you don't have a proper 2D view, you will not have a proper colored view. And this is another hint when you're scanning and you try to play with your Nyquist limit to make sure that you don't create regurgitation or create defects. So, and I try to get a beautiful four-chamber view. When I'm doing the four-chamber view as well, I'd like to look at the IVC and SVC opening, and I look at the colors of them, and also I try to look at the pulmonary veins opening into the left atrium. At least I have to find two pulmonary veins and look at them with color. Now, the third thing when you're scanning with a four-chamber and outflow is the Doppler now. When we do the Doppler secondary to findings with the colored view. And now I go for the outflow tract, I Doppler the pulmonary arteries and see if the flow is normal or obstructed. And of course, we have to know that in fetal life, we don't get so many gradients in the outflow tract. You have to look at the pulmonary valve itself. And in this case, we have to know that a gradient of pulmonary valve is not going to be, if you don't get a gradient, it doesn't mean that there's no pulmonary stenosis. You look at the anatomy and you measure the 2D measures of the valve. And also in the aortic valve, the same. So now we need to Doppler the outflow tracts, we need to Doppler pulmonary veins to make sure that these are the veins and not artifacts, and then we need to Doppler the SVC and IVC. Of course, when we go a little bit more caudal, we do something called the three vessels view, and the three vessels view goes by PAS, pulmonary artery, aorta, and SVC, and we want to make sure that the vessels are aligned the same way, and the pulmonary artery is a little bit bigger than the aorta, and the aorta and the SVC are more or less at similar size. So the size and alignment is very important. Three vessel view is very important for diagnosis of transposition and abnormalities of the arch. I think we'll stop here, and I think this is at least the basic idea of the four chamber view. Thank you very much. Allah.